Go.
Hi, what we have here today is a 1917 Eddystone. This is a well-made battle rifle used in World War I, which is not that well known to many people, but actually the British in World War I did not have enough shields to equip their troops. They were also in the process of designing another rifle that was based more on the Mauser type action. Contracted Winchester and a Remington subsidiary known as Eddystone to produce a new rifle in .303 caliber. By 1917, those companies had fulfilled their contract, but the U.S. now entered the war, and they were faced with the same situation. They did not have enough 1903 Springfield to equip their own troops that were going over to France. So again, those three companies said, we can produce a new rifle in .306 caliber with pretty much the same configuration as what we did for the British, and that's what they did. What's not well known is that most U.S. troops going over to France, two-thirds to three-quarters actually carried these rifles and not the 1903 Springfields. So this is a rather powerful .306 battle rifle. We'll do some shooting. That holds five rounds.
Yeah, that's what Sergeant York carried.
Yep. Okay. Yeah, cock on closing.
Very long range, accurate.
And he's shooting at 50 yards.
U.S. troops thought the rifle was too heavy. Sergeant Alvin York actually used one of these to kill and capture a large number of German soldiers. He did not use the 1903 Springfield as portrayed in that movie with Gary Cooper.
Mm.
And he also thought the rifle was a bit on the heavy side. But it served in World War I and also saw some service during World War II as well.
Yeah, my dad had those as a training rifle.
Right.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. He said that thing was so worn out that he had to put it on the 600 meter yard setting just to shoot at 200 yards. All right.
So once again, it's another.
Yep. All right.